Hello. Hey, we're live, and it's a little bit early. Just making sure I got everything together. Didn't want to rush it like I did yesterday. So anybody wants to show up, can. I do have the heartworm pills. If anybody's interested, just get Paul. Terry, how are you? I'm glad we get this little alone time, me and you. Denise Johnson is here. Good. Good. I'm just getting everything ready. I suppose you can hear me. Yes? Look at this. There's that ticket from when Pete Rose hit the big one. Giving that away tomorrow. Green seat. It's a green seat there, Nick. I didn't make that call. See if Mr. Morrow shows up here. That's the green ticket right there. Yeah, I'm doing okay, Paul. I love doing this show. I got some lights. Look at this, studio lights. And you see that from the hardware store? It's like the light switch. And I got them up there with Velcro. But they do a pretty good job for my Prius TV studio. So here it is without the lights. And just a little bit more. That's cool. Darren, how are you? Did you see my lights, Darren? You're a TV guy. Look, I got lights. They're on Velcro. Velcro to the ceiling. Just a little bit of fill, as they say in the biz. Hey, Edward, glad you're here. So there's our ticket. Here's my script. Don't forget, everybody. Time to share and like. Right there. Yeah, I know. Those are hardware store lights there, Darren. This is turning into a little TV studio. Two microphones. One on me and one I mic the back speaker. This is please share. There were four of you who shared yesterday, four or five. I know who doesn't show. I'm going to start naming names is what I'm going to do. Hey, David, good to see you. Oh, yeah, I do need an assistant. Gary Walters, was good chatting with you yesterday. Something else I thought about, the way the answers come in a weird order, is that maybe it depends on if you're on Wi-Fi or if you're on cellular. And I don't know if you text me, does that text have to go to a computer somewhere else and get to me? Or if we're on different phone servers, does that make it different? I have no idea, but I don't think there's much I can do about it. Which is good, because then it makes the show just fun. Because nobody's, you know, I was supposed to win. Everybody goes, oh, yeah. And that's what I like about you folks. I'm thinking I don't have, oh yeah. We have $150 in prizes to give away today. Yeah. Because I am not going to be here on Friday. Sorry about that. We are on hiatus for one day. My wife and I are going to see her folks up in Michigan. So, I was given permission to give away the Washington platform. Ooh, I better hurry. Washington platform gift card today. Randy Little's here. How about a little love for Randy Little? And we gave away your La Rosa card. That was very nice. And Randy, I got some new lights. I've been showing everybody else. I don't have time to show you. It's 5 o'clock on a weekday and time for Know-It-Alls, the only trivia game show brought to you live from a used Prius. This week, Know-It-Alls is brought to you by Washington Platform, Leopard Photography, and Cincinnati Dry Carpet Cleaning. Without further ado, here's the host, the mayor of Westwood. Put your hands together for Michael Flannery. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Hey, look at that, Brad Pitt's in the audience. Brad, thanks for coming. Drew Carey is here, get out of town, you. Glad to see you, Jerry. Jerry Springer, Normer, Jerry, how are you? We got a great crowd. We got a great show, and we're gonna have some fun. Now, if you're just tuning in and you haven't played, here's how you do it. Are you ready? Okay, let me tell you about it. I ask three multiple choice questions from here in my Prius. You type in the answers there in your comment box. Then, whoever answer gets to my phone first wins a valuable prize. Ooh. Gary Walter says, it's a great show because of Michael. Gary, you got to get out more often. I know it's hard with COVID and everything, but thank you, Gary. That's very nice of you. I'm having a blast. There's no way you can do a game show in a car. You know, that's what they tell me. That's what everybody tell me. Joe Wessel, glad to have you here. Okay, I'll hurry up. You only have five. All right, our next question is the Washington Platform question of the day. Boy, if you want oysters, jazz, and good drinks, this is where you go. They have been downtown Cincinnati serving Cincinnatians for over 150 years in the same location. And this is a great place. Live jazz on Friday and Saturday nights. And if you answer this question correctly, you will win a $50 gift card to Washington Platform. All right, and the question is, what is the address of Great American Ballpark? Is it 100 The Banks? Is it 1 Great American Ballpark? Or is it 100 Joe Nuxall Way? What is the address of Great American Ballpark? 100 The Banks? 1 Great American Ballpark? 100 Joe Nuxall Way? That's a toughie. Yeah, I remember that the address was of Synergy Field. It's not the same. A lot of people don't know that. It's a different address. They built it the same damn place, didn't they? Okay, let's see what we got here. Anybody go off the board? I love it when that happens. So Wessel's trying to answer all the questions. Yes, Pete Rose. Question two, Jerry Springer. All right. Man, you folks are good. You all got it right. It's 100 Joe Nuxall Way. And the first person to send me that one was none other than Paul Terry. Give him a round of applause. Now the phone, it just went dark in here. Am I having a stroke? What's going on here? Okay, I gotta find out why it's dark all of a sudden. Wait a minute. Give Paul some love. There you go. All right, Paul. $50. That's a great prize. That really is a good prize. Not as good as the prize we're giving away tomorrow. Look at this. A green ticket from September 11th, 1985, when Pete Rose hit his big, the number, I always get the number wrong, 4,192 or 4,942 or 3. Anyway, right now, our next question, it's time for the Leopard Photography question of the day. I had lunch with Gary Leppert today and Charlie Stout, the owner of Cincinnati Dry Carpet Cleaning. You know when I pause like that? That's the Adderall wearing off. Yeah, I have ADD like nobody's business. The Adderall wears off and then words disappear. But we had lunch today. We had a little sponsors meeting. It was good. And from now on, when you win a prize, you send me your phone number. And then I'll give you a call or a text and tell you how to claim it. Instead of waiting for them to do it, I'm going to take the front on this. But yeah, I got an incoming call from Cincinnati Public Schools. Sorry. Leopard photography. Photo of the day. You win this prize and you will get 2 videotapes digitized and put on a DVD for free. They not only take great photos, but they archive and save your family heirlooms. Photos, 16 millimeter, 8 millimeter, it doesn't matter. They can put it on a DVD and you will get 2 free tapes if you answer this question correctly. And the question is, are you ready? Where did Andy Williams grow up? Fairfax, Paris Park, or Cheviot? Andy Williams grew up in Cincinnati. Now I can't find everybody. Am I still on the air? Yeah, I don't see anybody's answers. Well, this is working out just great! How am I supposed to see? Okay, was it Fairfax, Terrace Park, or Cheviot? I hope you guys know what the answer is. Oh, are you over here? Nope, you're over there. I can't see what you're typing if you're typing. Aw, man. Damn CPS. There we go. All right, here we go. Was it Cheviot? What were the answers? Fairfax, Terrace Park, or Cheviot? Let's see. Yeah, CPS. I could do without anything from CPS. And Joe Wessels! No! Paul Terry! No! Darren Cox! Yes! Give Darren a round of applause. He grew up in Cheviot. I had no idea that he grew up in Cheviot. That's like a 9-iron from where I live. Give Darren some love. Darren works at Channel 5 and a damn fine stand-up comedian. Not that there's any place for us to do that anymore right now, Darren. But, yeah, Cheviot. I live in Westwood. I don't mean to brag, you know, but... Yeah, it's kind of money I'm bringing down now. Westwood. Been living there a long time. I should have noticed when all the police were moving out. Might have been a good time to sell. Who knows? Who's to say? All right. Nick, you think he grew up in Houston Woods? Was raised by squirrels? I keep poking Gary in the eye. Sorry about that right there. All right, here we go. Now, ladies and gentlemen, you are just in time. Right now, it is time for the Cincinnati Dry Carpet Cleaning question of the day. That's right, Cincinnati Dry Carpet Cleaning. You will, if you get this question correct, you will get 350 square feet of carpet cleaning from Cincinnati's best carpet cleaner, CincinnatiDryCarpetCleaning.com. And not only that, the owner will come out himself to clean your carpet. And all he wants to happen is for it to be the best experience in carpet cleaning you've ever had. And when he's done, 45 minutes later, it's dry. That's the great part. It's not sopping wet for hours. All right. Can everybody see me okay? Yeah? All right. So, the question is, the Cincinnati dry carpet cleaning question is this. What Cincinnati businessman was famous for telling his customers, hurry back, We got rent to pay. Was it Izzy Cadet, Cash Ambergy, or Ted Gregory? Which Greater Cincinnati businessman was famous for telling customers, "Hurry back, we got rent to pay"? Izzy Cadet, Cash Ambergy, or Ted Gregory? If you get this correct, you will win 350 square feet of carpet cleaning from Cincinnati Dry Carpet Cleaning. Let me see who we got going on now. All right. We got, you guys did good. Gary Walters said Cash Ambergy. So sorry. Paul Terry said Ted. And you aren't going to believe this, but, and I'm checking it twice, Randy Little, Huckleberry Joe, nope, that wasn't it. But Darren Cox said Izzy Cadet.
Yes, 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 yes!
And I guess she's right. That is the correct answer. Give Darren a round of applause. That is one. Oh, that's my job. I'm supposed to give Darren a round of applause. There you go. I'm believing that this is all real. You know that. That's the sad part. Oh, man. Have you had any Izzy's lately? I was looking on their website and found out, first off, something I already knew, makers of the world's greatest Reuben sandwich, bar none. And their restaurants are open. Izzy's restaurants are open, Izzy Cadet's. You can eat in, carry out, and they're doing everything you're supposed to do to keep their customers safe. And what's amazing is they've been here serving Cincinnati great food for 100 years. 100 years. And that means that the Cadets and the Geysers have been making great food for Cincinnati through the Depression, through two world wars, civil unrest. Through it all, they've been serving food to us. So you know, a little pandemic isn't gonna stop them. Stop by Izzy's. I was just thinking about this. Just get one of those sandwiches and say thanks. Well, that's it for today. I've had a blast. I'm glad you came. I had a good time with the sponsors of the show at lunch. Gary and Charlie, thank you very much. We had La Rosa's. Ooh, yeah. So folks, tomorrow we give away the Cincinnati Reds ticket for Pete Rose broke Ty Cobb's record. This ticket stub is from that very night. Tell all your friends. Please share. Please be safe, and we'll see you tomorrow, kids. I know it all. That's right. I can't get to the button to put on that mask. See if anybody has anything they want to get out. All right. God bless y'all, and thanks for coming to Know It Alls again. We'll see you tomorrow.